Hey guys, the question is, Don Lieberman and Associates, a CPA firm, uses job order costing to capture the cost of its audit jobs. There were no audit jobs in the process at the beginning of November. Listed below are data concerning the three audit jobs worked on during November. Here is the data. You can find the whole question in the description box. Overhead costs are applied to jobs on the basis of auditor hours, and the predetermined overhead rate is $55 per auditor hour. The Sunland Incorporation job is the only incomplete job at the end of November. Actual overhead for the month was $12,800. First of all, we have to calculate cost of each job. So, cost of each job. First of all, for Sunland Incorporation. So, here, direct material cost $710. Then auditor labor cost $6,000 plus then overhead applied. So here overhead applied is equal to auditor hours, which is 78 multiplied by overhead rate per auditor hour $55. So here 78 multiplied by 55, 4290 plus 710 plus 6000 plus 4290 $11,000. Now we will calculate for Carla Vista Incorporation. So here $440 direct material cost, then auditor labor cost $7,000 plus again overhead applied 93 hours multiplied by $55 is equal to $5,115 plus $440 plus $7,000, so $12,555. Now for Sandil Corporation. So here direct material cost 230 plus auditor labor cost 4075 plus number of auditor hours 48 multiplied by $55. So here 230 plus 4075 plus 48 multiplied by 55. $6,945. So these are our cost of each job. Now the second question is, indicate the balance of the service contracts in process account at the end of November. So here Sunland Incorporation job is the only incomplete job. So balance in service contract in process account is equal to total cost of Sunland Incorporation. So here the value will be total cost of Sunland Incorporation, which is $11,000. So our balance in service contract in process account is $11,000. Now the C point is, calculate the ending balance of operating overhead account for November. So here ending balance of operating overhead account, so it is equal to actual overhead minus applied overhead. Here our actual overheads are $12,800 while overheads are 78 + 93 + 48 hours multiplied by our per auditor hour $55. So here it is equal to 12,045. So is equal 12,800 minus 12,045. So our balance in operating overhead account is equal to 755. So here is our solution. In case any doubt, you can ask me through comment box, and don't forget to subscribe my YouTube channel and hit the bell icon. And thank you for watching my video.